Good morning, friends and fellow traders. This is Doug Campbell with Right Way Options, and this is the morning market prep video for April 19th, 2023. Well, I don't know if you were like me, but yesterday was just one of those frustrating days of chop. We were trying to move up in the pre-market. At the time I recorded the morning prep video, we were up 130 points in the Dow. And then Goldman Sachs came out and reported, and that disappointed the market. We kind of went flat. We ended up staying flat pretty much the entire day, just chopping back and forth with very low volume as we waited for the earnings reports from Netflix, which also kind of came up with a disappointment. So now we're facing a market that's looking a little bit bearish this morning. So what does all this mean for today? Well, how about we settle in, let's buckle up, let's get ready for the Wednesday edition of the Morning Market Prep video. Good morning once again, everyone, and thanks so much for being here. I do truly appreciate it. Well, let's take a peek at these charts and see if we can figure out how we might want to approach the market today. We've got a big day of earnings data coming our way, and not a whole lot on the economic calendar, but we seem to have all of a sudden come into some uncertainty. There has been this amazing amount of confidence that earnings were just going to smoke it. They were just going to be great. And unfortunately, we're not really seeing that. Although the majority of the earnings so far have beat estimates, those have been really lowered estimates, and they really haven't been anything that have fired up the market all that much. And so we're still kind of stuck in this range. And as you can see here in the diamonds, just stuck in this trading range here in the market. And now that uncertainty is starting to creep up with Goldman missing and Netflix missing. Everyone's beginning to wonder, is this earnings season going to be all as good as we have been kind of portraying out there? We also have this problem that cropped up today where the UK reported their inflation and came in stronger than expected, up 10.1%. They were looking for a 9.8%. That's got our bonds continuing, the bond yields continuing to move higher here in the market, adding additional pressures to the market. And although we have really tried to ignore it, like it just doesn't matter, well, that might be coming into a little bit more focus here today if that continues to rise. So let's say we get those bulls inspired here today. Well, I would say maybe a retest of these highs up here would be possible. And once again, if we push up into this area and we can punch through this area right up here to that resistance, looks like the likely place we go in the chart. But if those bears continue with the inspiration this morning, and I'm not saying they will, if they continue with this inspiration to move down, we've got a fairly substantial gap down setting up this morning. Well, I would look for some retests of these lows and maybe even a push down into this price support in the chart. Now you'll notice that we're just starting to slip. And remember, you can draw these lines a lot of different ways, but just kind of starting to slip beyond that trend here in the chart. We're still holding above support levels, so there's nothing bad here, and our technicals in the chart remain good. So if the bulls can hang on to these support levels, no harm, no foul. The question will be if those bears really find something to grab a hold of. If they were to break down below this level, then we've got some problems maybe coming in the market. Let's take a look at our SPY, SPY. Well, SPY pressed up there into that price resistance yesterday, trying to gap through, and it tried hard to get to inspire some buyers early yesterday morning. But then, well, it just kind of got overwhelmed with a little bit of selling, leaving behind maybe an uncertain pattern right there against that price resistance of the chart. So if those bulls can find inspiration today, well, I would look for another retest of this area up here and possibly a pop through. We'll see if that comes around or not. And if those bears find some inspiration. Well, maybe a retest down here into this little price support area right here. And if that were to fail, well, then it's a pretty big move if we start dropping into these other levels of price support in the chart. So watch carefully for that. And you can see we're right on that place where we need to make that decision. Either we're going to hold this trend and break through this resistance above, or we're going to kind of start slipping that trend here just a little bit. Now, I don't think there's anything wrong here. We could stay stuck in this trading range for a little while and still come out, you know, on the bullish or bearish side. This isn't reason for panic. Our technicals are still strong here in the SPY, but maybe we're starting to see just a little bit of uncertainty creep in. If we take a look at our QQQ, now QQQ also rallied up, hit that resistance. You might look at this as that possibility of a double top high. You might look at it as, no, this is just nothing more than an uncertain consolidation, and we're just moving out here toward the trend. And I have mentioned before, trend is very important in these charts. And as you can see, we're just resting this move out toward the trend. Now, what's going to be interesting here today is if those bulls find inspiration and can reverse this bearishness that we've got going this morning, I would look for a retest up here to see if we can pop through there again. And if they cannot, if the bulls don't find that inspiration, you want to notice that we're kind of dropping below that little support area right in there this morning, gapping below that. So that would mean the next level of price support would be back down here, and we might be testing that trend if that were the case. So keep a close eye on that. We could start shaking a little bit of that bullish enthusiasm hard if we push down into that trend and even break it. Technicals remain very bullish, however. And then if we take a look at our IWM has just been, boy, it just can't make a decision here. It's up one day, down one day, up one day, down one day. And we pushed into these price resistance levels here in the chart yesterday and then backed away, leaving a dark cloud cover in the chart. Now, you might notice in here that there is a little bit of a trend. So if those bears find that inspiration today and can hold that trend and maybe hold this support in here, probably no problem occurring here. But if that were to fail, that would be the issue here for the market. So if those bears really find lots of inspiration and they break down through this support, well, that next support is substantially lower. So keep that in mind. If the bulls find that inspiration, then I would look for a retest of this resistance here in the chart and that opportunity to maybe break that downtrend here if they can find that bullish reason to really keep pushing. If we take a look at our VIX, well, our VIX continues to sink. There's no fear here in the market, which seems to be remarkable to me when we've had so much money leave the market going into money market funds. And I'm talking record levels of money leaving the market looking for some safety. And we seem to have no concern about banking issues or anything at all right now. And so our VIX has been unusually confident. That could mean a couple of things. First, it could mean there is no issue in the market here to be worried about at all. Everything is bullish, everything is great. Or it can mean that we've become overly complacent. And when we get overly complacent in the market, we can get these big reversals, these big point moves. Now, I'm not saying that is the case, but boy, it just seems like we're being a little bit on the complacent side here in the market with maybe some overconfidence about how this earnings season is going to turn out. So just watch that closely. Now, if we take a look at our T2122, our T2122, once again, we pushed up yesterday, pushed up into that resistance area, the bearish resistance area of the chart, kind of that overbought area. And Well, maybe looking for a little bit of pullback here today. Well, a pretty substantial gap down at the moment, but it is improving as the morning goes on. We've got a little pump coming in to ease some of that gap down pressure here this morning. So watch that closely here. What we do know is if the bulls find some good inspiration in here, well, we've got some upside opportunity here. But if the bears continue what they're showing here in the pre-market pushing down, well, we've certainly got a big opportunity to the downside. Doesn't mean that we technically damage any of the charts. It doesn't mean any of our support levels have to break, but maybe we need a little bit of relief on that upside drive trying to break out. So watch that close. And then our T2108, well, T2108 yesterday was a little bit flat. You can see it got a little bit of elevation in there. About 48% of the stocks holding above their 40-day moving average. And you can see we're testing some price resistance here in the chart. But the good news is we did break through that downtrend. We're showing that bullishness, but we may be just a little bit overstretched in the short term and need a little bit of profit-taking relief coming into the market. And our T2107, well, T2107 also kind of flat yesterday, not doing much of anything. You can see we're kind of stuck between a support level and a resistance level in the chart. The good news is we have snuck out from underneath that downtrend. 46% of the stocks holding above the 200-day. So kind of middle of the road here on T2108 and T2107. And then if we take a look at our T2101, well, T2101 hooked over yesterday, showing us that momentum has shifted. But honestly, I don't know how we get much momentum out of a day where volume was extremely low and we just chopped in a really tiny range. So I'm not sure we're getting good data out of that indicator at all. Let's take a look at our economic calendar here for today. We've got a couple of things to be paying attention to, but pretty light day on that economic calendar. Our mortgage applications have already come in substantially bearish here this morning, a pretty substantial decline on those. We're going to have, you can see, purchase index minus 10%, composite minus 8.8. So a little bit of bearishness coming in there on those mortgage applications as our rates rise, as our bond yields continue to go up. As you can see, we've got a petroleum status report here this afternoon. May or may not help move the market. Certainly, if we see supply declines, that could move the oil sector higher. If we see a build in supplies, that can move the sector lower. So just keep a close eye on it. We've got a 20-year bond auction here today. Is it important? Yes, because those yields keep rising, but the market just wants to ignore it. They just don't want to pay attention to bonds right now at all. It doesn't make any difference to them. We've got a beige book here this afternoon, and we've got a couple of Fed speakers here this afternoon to be watching. Now, keep in mind, as we plan for Thursday, got a lot of data coming Thursday with earnings reports, but then we've got jobless claims, a Philly Fed, housing market index. So those are things that can be definitely market moving. Two of those happen before the market opened, and then existing home sales will be after that. We also have some more bond auctions, short-term bond auctions. We got several Fed speakers in there on the day, just kind of a parade of them. So we'll want to be watching for their comments. Let's take a look at our earnings calendar today, and our earnings really ramp up a bit today. A lot more on the plate, so I will not be able to cover them all. If you want to catch the full list of notables here for today, make sure you click the link just below the title of the video. That'll take you back to the morning blog, and you can catch that full list of notables. So first off, let's take a look. We've got Alcoa in here. One of the things we have seen lately is those shiny metals have been doing pretty good, but aluminum is not one of those that have been doing all that great. So we'll want to keep an eye on that report here this morning. LA Financial reporting today. It looks like we're trying to get just a little bit of a pop out of that. Regional banks have been kind of uncertain here, and we've got several of those today on the regional side. We've also got some big banks in here reporting. Morgan Stanley reporting today. We're going to hear from USB. We're also going to hear from Zion today. So keep an eye on those. Some of the techs out there that could be interesting, NDAQ will be reporting today. Keep an eye on that. LRCX, kind of an interesting one to be paying attention to here today. And we will also hear from Tesla later this afternoon. So watch carefully for that. We're also going to get a little steel today. Steel Dynamics will be reporting, so it might be worth keeping an eye on that. Let's take a look at a few charts that could be setting up for today. But before we do that, guys, just really quickly, if you can do me that favor once again, that is, if this is the first time you've seen these videos, click that subscribe button on YouTube and also click that bell icon when it pops up, so you'll be notified every time I post a video. And if you find these videos to be useful or helpful, if you could please continue to click those thumbs up buttons, leave a brief comment, that helps the channel to continue to grow. And also, if you could do me that favor and share this video out on your social media feeds, that also helps us reach new folks and continue the growth of the channel. So thank you for everyone who does do that, and thank you for the kind support to this channel. I do truly appreciate it. Let's take a look at some of these charts setting up. And remember, guys, these are not recommendations to buy or sell any security. You're going to have to do your own due diligence. Be very, very careful in here with the volatility that we're likely to see with all of these earnings reports. Anything is possible. We have to be watching for big point intraday whipsaws on these reports, and also that potential as we're starting to do some of these big earnings reports after the bell. Full overnight reversals are possible, so make sure you're planning your risk carefully. First off, let's take a look at a couple stocks that I thought was looking pretty good yesterday, starting to show an interesting pattern. Take a look at Dollar General. Dollar General trying to break out of this downtrend, and you guys can probably see it in here, that inverted head and shoulders pattern starting to show itself. And we found a little bit of price support, put in some bullish action in there yesterday. Dollar General may be about ready to move on up on this downtrend break. So watch that carefully here in Dollar General. Take a look at Disney. Disney's also hanging in there. There was a glowing report out by one of the major banks saying 30% upside opportunity or something in it. It didn't make much of a move yesterday, and you can see with the bearishness we got this morning, it could be a little bit to the downside, just a tiny bit. But let's watch this support level and watch as this consolidates. There may be that opportunity for some upside moves there in Disney in the near future. Watch that one closely. As you guys know, I've been keeping an eye on this BMY. Very nice pattern, very nice resting pattern, consolidating move in here. And one of the things that we've been seeing is some of the healthcare sector has been really, really strong in this market. And we'll talk about some defensive sector stocks here in a second. They have been surprisingly strong. BMY holding this price support, I would look for that next opportunity that might pop up through there. You can see we're right out there on that trend, so it could occur at any time. I would keep an eye on that. In that same kind of old boring stock area, Procter & Gamble looking good here. This is that consumer defensive sector, and these nice boring dividend payers have been showing a lot of strength, and you can see breaking through resistance, holding that area in there, and I would just be watching for that next opportunity to the upside. You could kind of put Pfizer in that same group, but boy, this thing had a little bit of trouble last few days and starting to show a bit of bearishness here. So this one I had an alert on, and you can see it didn't trigger that alert. So I'm kind of, this is a wait and see, and this may be a full-on failure that's coming here into Pfizer. We might catch a little support here, But just goes to show that you don't want to anticipate a trade. You want to wait for that trade. You want to get proof that buyers are actually stepping through. Put an alert on those trades and wait for them. Then let's take a look at some of these other defensive sector stocks looking unbelievably good. Hershey has just, my goodness, there's got to be a lot of chocolatey goodness spreading around out there someplace with what's happening here in Hershey. Lots of strength in this move. Good strong dividend payer, and you can see maybe setting up for some more upside opportunities. If you look right through here on the trend, it's right there where you would be expecting that to potentially occur. And we're seeing even some stocks that you might not think would be doing so well in a uncertain economic condition that we're in the market, but take a look at Walmart. Nice little pop through that resistance, holding it as support. Buyer stepping up, looking to push Walmart on higher here. So a lot of support in some of these defensive sector stocks, and you want to look for those good dividend payers out there for those setups, because they are really looking pretty good. So with that, everyone, hey, I want to wish you all a fantastic day. Thanks so much for being here. I do truly appreciate it. Hope you got something out of this. Hope you have a fantastic day, and I'll see you right back here bright and early Thursday morning. Wish each and every one of you all the best. Take care.